Really quickly before this video starts, this one video is actually one of 5 videos that's in my 7-day Win Big and Music Networking course. Now it's a free course. You probably already have it if you've been a part of my newsletter for a while because I just sent it out to people. If you haven't found it or you missed it for some reason, the instructions to find that in your email will be in the description below, but also you can join it using the link in the description below if you aren't a part of it and you seem to be interested. Again, this is only one of 5 videos that are in that course. I'll probably post one more, but other than that, enjoy. Bow. What's up, everybody? Once again, it's BrandMan, Sean, and I gotta talk about 3 things that you should not do while you are networking. And for number one, I'm just gonna go ahead and hop into a story, see if you can guess what it is. Now we're gonna keep rolling for there. These girls came up to me one time. They start messaging me. I recognize one girl. She came to one of my festivals and she was like, yo, Sean, I really like what you do. And we kind of had somewhat history, knowing similar people, but I didn't really have a personal relationship with her. But I was like, yeah, you know what? Cool. Well, if you want to, I know you're trying to get into this space and I'll give you some advice. Just tell me what you got going on. Long story short, she had a homegirl that was also supposed to be working with her. And so it was these 2 girls that I really didn't have a relationship with. And this girl was talking about her homegirl who didn't make it to a meeting and was basically saying all these interesting things about her that apparently had happened like the night before. Just a lot of negative type stuff. But when the meeting ended, as far as I knew, I was gonna have another meeting possibly one day with both of those girls. That never happened. However, the other girl reached out to me, and when she started talking to me, she started talking about the girl that I met with first is two-faced, and apparently they had a bad breakup recently. She's just not a great person to be around. She doesn't know what's wrong with her, yada, 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 yada. Either way it goes, number one is don't talk badly about people. The reason you should not be talking bad about people is, for one, a lot of times it's gonna come off negatively on you. Them girls telling me that stuff about each other, whatever they were going through, it didn't make me say, oh, I want to go with this one, I want to go with that one, or this one has done worse stuff than this one, so what she did makes sense. I was just like, yo, I don't want to touch this situation. I really don't want to work with these girls in the future at all. And not only that, a lot of times you don't just cast a negative light on yourself when you're talking badly about people. You also have to consider the fact that the industry is so small. One way or another, it's likely going to get back to the people that you are talking about. Yes, sometimes you need a vent and you're frustrated, and there are some people who just do some stupid stuff or ethically messed up stuff in the industry, so you might want to vent to your small circle, your trusted circle. Hopefully you have something like that, but just generally speaking, don't loosely talk badly about people. Now let's go ahead and hop into number 2. Do not get upset with people for not responding to you. Do not get upset with people for not giving you the time that you think they should be giving you. There's so many of these cases. I'm gonna have a personal story. I'm gonna try to do a personal story for most of these. But what happens a lot of times, I know so many people, they'll send a message or they'll DM somebody and they're waiting for a reply. I put my music in this thing, or I wrote like the craftiest message. I've spent 10 minutes working on this thing, 30 minutes working on 4 sentences, and then nothing. Let me hop into the story first, and then I'm sure you can figure out why from there once again. Now, unfortunately, earlier this year, at the time I'm recording this video, I had 3 people pass very closely in time frames to each other. Completely different scenarios. One person passed 3 weeks later, another person passed, and then about 4 weeks later, another person passed. At the same time, I have huge responsibilities in what I'm working on. I'm not just working within an organization, I was leading multiple organizations and trying to continue to do this YouTube page at the same time. I didn't have time, and I really honestly didn't feel like doing anything. In this time, apparently somebody sent me an email and apparently I opened it up. So just to give you an idea, there were some days where I would just open a lot of messages, not read them, and then just click them unread because I couldn't get myself to focus. And I would say, you know what? I forgot anything related to this YouTube stuff. It's secondary. I gotta double down on my real life responsibilities and continue to take care of my family. And again, this email that I'm talking about in this instance apparently got open. I get a message one day. As a matter of fact, let me see if I could read the email. I'm gonna go through this email, and the person says, for one, not really sure if you opened the email, but I can see you opened it 6 days ago. Basically saying, I gave you plenty of time to respond
And I don't know why you're ignoring me. You shouldn't be. I don't know if you have a problem with me. The respectable thing to do would be to respond. So what's going through my mind at this time? All right, person, there's people that are way more important to me than you in my life right now that actually haven't even got a chance to hear back from me because of what I got going on and the things that I have to handle and what I'm going through. That's not even anything against you. I just don't know you. And there's people that are literally more important that I have to tend to. This is extra for a later time. And so I told the person, because I'm pretty straightforward, hey, never read the email, but overall, I'm not feeling your approach. The person then negatively reacts again, and that person doesn't like that I didn't like their disrespectful message. And then I'm like, all right, whatever. And next thing you know, they kind of spitball on me, all this stuff, whoop-de-whoop, it doesn't matter. And another person randomly hit me up in my DMs one time. Okay, cool. Don't go through all my DMs all the time. But this person, when I finally make it to their message, says, I don't know why you don't respond to your DMs, man. You don't have that many followers. Do you think that's a way to get me to respond? And if I could think about this situation, I think there was a little bit of overlap in the period I mentioned in that previous story where I had to go dark a little bit. So that probably extended the time I replied even more so. That doesn't make me want to help you. The reason this is such a big point, guys, is when you get angry at people and you take all of this stuff personally, it forces you to project negatively on those other people. You get salty. And a lot of times there's no reason to be salty. People got real life stuff that they're dealing with. People are also busy. You're a random person trying to come into their world. A random person trying to come into their world. Remember that they already have a life before you. You can't expect just because you even write a nice message that the person will respond to you at all. You can hope for that and you can be thankful for that if that happens, but you can't expect it. And why this is so important is I understand that feeling, that little slight rejection, that feeling, it sucks, straight up. And I feel that stuff sometimes too still. However, at the end of the day, there's been so many instances when eventually I might actually run into that person or that person finds out about me or reaches out to me in another way and they literally have no idea that I messaged them before. I've done the same thing with other people. There's one person that after I ended up meeting with this person and then after meeting with this person once or maybe even twice, long down the road, I'm going through Facebook. Never go through Facebook messages. This guy hit me up on Facebook already trying to get my attention just to talk. And I never replied because I never go on my Facebook messages. Don't look at them. And then this guy hit me up on Twitter and he hit me up on my email. And this is over an extended period of time. And every single message when I looked at his past messages were still pleasant, just trying to get my attention, no big deal. If I had found an old message and he had an attitude, I couldn't say I would be so willing to meet with that person again. But me and him have met up multiple times and I don't charge him for any of the advice I give him or anything like that. We just chop it up, say what's up, catch up on things, and now I consider him kind of a friend in the industry. So that's the second don't, people. I hope you guys take that one seriously, really take it to heart, because it messes up so many people. Now skipping to number three, don't go around the connect. Don't go around your connect specifically. Now what does this mean? If somebody introduces you to somebody else, do not try to go around that person in the future to try to do business with that person. Or more specifically, if you guys are working together, let's say y'all are setting up some kind of show or setting up something and this person is working with maybe a bigger artist or bigger name and they're hooking you up and giving you an opportunity that you never would have had, don't try to get back to those people in the future, at least without that person's permission who originally connected you with them. Otherwise, you're gonna look like you a slimy person. You're gonna look like you're trying to go around them and cut them out of the scenario and push them to the side. Why this is so important? It's a simple fact that it happens all the time. People play these games all the time in the industry. People use people to get to other people. And if people start to think that you're a rat, people start to think that you're a snake, they're going to spread that into this small community. And these words spread quickly. And that could prevent a lot of other relationships from building for you. A lot of times you'll reach out to this person and that person will say, hey, yo, your homie had reached out to me, and then the person that you tried to skip over will find out. And now they'll say, yo, no, don't work with them because they don't have my permission. So you're messing yourself up in the first place. There are scenarios where this person positions you so you can help build a relationship with that next person. And now you don't need them all the time. And that's great.
but just be sure that that's what it is. Sometimes it's the nuances, sometimes it's clear to be able to tell the difference. But definitely if it's a cold outreach and you barely have any interaction with those people at all, they know your name just a little bit, don't try to hit them up in the future for a track or hit them up in the future to do something for them, particularly around the same type of business that your connect connected you for. Because then once again, you're looking like you're cutting that person straight up out of the equation. And if that person has a relationship with them, they don't want that person to be mistreated. So if you look like you're mistreating the person that they had a relationship with and actually connected them with you, why would they actually want to work with you? In the industry, it's so much more relationships than just straight up money. Keep that in mind, remember that. But other than that, if you like this video, go ahead, hit that like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.